This is a super exciting time to be an electrical engineer. As I walk around the laboratory or I hear from my colleagues about what they've added or new classes they're developed, it makes me wish I was a kid again.
This is a very fast-changing field.
Electrical engineering is playing an essential role in the implementation of artificial intelligence systems, quantum computing, 5G communications, the Internet of Things, and so on.
I think it's very exciting.
So the College of Computing has multiple roles, but one of the roles is ensuring the excellence of the core of computing. And another role is in helping facilitate the infusion of the computing in other disciplines. And I would say with respect to electrical engineering, it's really both of those roles.
We always want to revisit our curriculum periodically. But I think in this case, the main thing was that our conception of the discipline and how excited we were as faculty, we didn't think that was being adequately translated into the curriculum. As we think about not just the concepts that we want to teach students, but the way that we do that, rigor flows throughout. Rigor to me means I understand to some deep level how things work and why they work. Over about a 2-year process, we took in a lot of information and we distilled that into a set of principles and we designed to those principles.
It was really like a blank slate reconstruction of what it meant to be an electrical engineer, something that we haven't done in decades.
So the first part is the core. So we have a set of classes that we thought all electrical engineers should know. All of these have hands-on laboratory activities, so we get the students early learning, playing in the laboratory. These classes feed into a new class that we developed called Engineering for Impact. There the idea is, can you design and build complete hardware-software systems?
The goal of the course was to design some system that could monitor the number of people at a bus stop. In this project, we're not just writing firmware. We're also building out all these PCBs and designing them and manufacturing and fabricating them. What we ended up building is essentially a thermometer and a Bluetooth sniffer that work together to figure out what is the current heat experienced by people and how many people are currently in this area. And I think that was the most meaningful thing to me, was we were building something that actually could have an impact.
There's a real temptation to really embrace and have the students immediately use the advanced tools so they can basically do state-of-the-art stuff. But our concern is that it obfuscates, that hides a lot of the fundamental sometimes. So those tools will break, they're imperfect. So when they do break, if you don't understand how it works, you're not a very good engineer.
Everyone needs to know programming and algorithms. Computing now has become an essential tool in many academic disciplines, as well as in many sectors of the economy. Programming and algorithms is not just foundational for EE, but also a core part of all engineering education.
I was on the EE curriculum committee that basically rethought what were the foundation subjects, how did we want students to be able to explore what electrical engineering means today, and part of that was developing tracks that the students could dive a little deeper into. They don't see how these classes fit together to allow them to basically have a career, but the existence of a track basically helps them visualize that.
In this class, we start out with devices to design some of these key components of silicon photonics. Then we go up to systems. So how can you take these different devices, put them together into systems, and then really hit on emerging applications that are coming up in the field? I think students are excited to see something like this where they can get their hands dirty with the silicon photonics lab and then also get a really deep understanding of the devices and how they can use them.
We now have this quantum track, which is really important, where students can actually take a concentration in quantum. And so those students have seen mostly quantum from an engineering perspective.
You need to have an interdisciplinary view. You can't really understand how quantum computers work without understanding the algorithms. And you can't understand the algorithms without understanding the physics, because the two of them are still so closely connected.
At the end of the class, we actually bring in people from different companies, from startups, from large companies, from government labs, and they give their perspective of the field.
The students aren't using some academic theoretical framework. They're using what you would basically deploy in the field when you go into industry. We like to have them do a project for them to actually visualize a thing, see all the bugs that come up along the way, actually get into a debug, a struggle cycle. That's engineering at the end of the day. We don't want it to be all canned lab.
I'm truly excited about the new curriculum as it prepares our students for a career in industry, entrepreneurship, or academia.
We wanted to pick a new name and number to be able to signal this revision and this transformational change.
So as we're thinking about what to name this degree program, we decided on electrical engineering with computing. I think it clearly communicates that this is an electrical engineering degree, while also emphasizing the deep relationship between electrical engineering and computing, both that electrical engineers have an important role in developing computing systems, but also that computing is important in the practice of electrical engineering. And we decided that it's time for a new number, 65.
It is a recognition of a flagship program for electrical engineering with the reorganization of EECS into three units, electrical engineering, computer science, and artificial intelligence and decision making.
It puts MIT at the forefront of revisions that various places are considering in the electrical engineering curriculum. I get excited when people look at revising technological curricula because of that very rapid change in technology and how it's being used in the world and how it impacts people's lives.
I'm confident that our students will go on to have a tremendous impact in the field.